Well, the house is actually quite new. It might not look it, but we've only been here 6-7 years. We have this inspiration from a sketch and an old magazine that we bought in a car boot sale. And Nick built this over the course of about 4 years, because at the same time we were converting some outbuildings as holiday lets. And we remembered we'd been to somewhere in Rajasthan, which was this massive reclamation yard, over 50 acres. And over the course of a week, we filled 2 40-foot containers to bring back. We used a lot of that in our holiday lets. Surplus we've used in here, and we've now come to the end of our conversion work. So we need to look at what we can dispose of and make a bit more space.
They've got a dragon on the roof.
Yes.
A massive dragon.
I'm liking
that's
that.
Something else, isn't it?
Liking that a lot.
Hello.
Hello.
How you doing?
Welcome.
Can't miss this place, can you?
I am too. Yeah.
What a place.
Fantastic.
Can't wait to see inside.
Do come in. Follow me.
Wow. Look at this. This is amazing.
It gets better, doesn't it?
It's wonderful. We've got a whole tree in the middle of the house as well. Wow. Incredible. I love touches like this. Just leave the big bolt hanging in the end of it.
Yeah.
I like that. It's nice. Inventive.
Belgrove is, well, it's certainly different, and I love it. I think it's so interesting.
Oh, look at this. Oh, look at that ceiling. So did you guys just design the place, just come up with it? Because it's almost like a big spiral, or what's
pretty
it designed
well.
Off?
We took inspiration from an old artist's impression of a house that was supposed to have been built in St. Petersburg.
It's that wonderful thing when somebody just gets the rule book and tosses it over the shoulder and just said, I'm going to do this.
It's really comfortable. And then you've got lots and lots of this Indian bits and bobs here. There's a real mix of stuff. The majority is Indian, isn't it?
It's what might be politely called eclectic. We used a lot of Indian furniture and materials in our holiday lets, and what was left over, basically, we used here. Mm-hmm. But they're mixed in with, for example, a Chinese cabinet we brought back from Malaysia, and there's some Balinese pieces.
Amazing. So you've travelled a lot, then?
We've travelled a fair bit, and we do like shopping.
I can tell.
Clearly the reason we're here, even though it's such a long way from home, is the fact that it's obviously different. You know, this is a house call with a difference. This is not the norm. And I am now I've arrived and I've had a good look inside. I'm very pleased we're here.
Oh, yes.
When are we moving in?
We'll take it. If you could have this house for nothing, but you had to live in it with me, would you?
Don't know. Who would kill who first? That'd be the question, wouldn't it?
James, how you doing?
Well,
nice to meet you. Drew?
Come in, please. Hi,
how are you doing? Nice you all right?
Yep.
Thanks for
Thank
having
you.
Us. Marvellous. Oh, my. Wow. James, amazing.
Thank you very much.
Amazing. So tell me about the place, then.
We've been here for roughly 1,000 years. still in the same spot.
So you farm here, then, still?
It's a farming estate. There yep. are 19 tenant farmers and 25... cottage which we let out.
I'm hoping for some really good finds, because will I ever get the opportunity to go through a house like this again in this condition? I don't think so. I'm sort of a bit gobsmacked, really.
I'm
so
trying to work out where you're going to start.
I don't know where to start.
There's so many places.
I don't know where to start. There's so much in here. I mean, it's just mind-blowing. Look at that. Wow. It's like a time capsule.
Nothing's really been altered at all.
But nothing in the main body of the buildings for sale. These
no.
are all. That's all
no.
out of the way.
Out
okay.
of the way.
I'm a bit gobsmacked. Can we have a look around?
Yes.
Do you mind?
Welcome. No.
Which way first?
Shall we go?
Yep.
Show you
sure.
through to the saloon.
This is the most quintessentially English country house interior I have ever seen, bar none. Everything about it is just screaming total authenticity. Age, patina, colour. It just goes on and on and on. If you've got millions and millions of pounds and you employ the best interior designers in the world, they can just about get close to this, but never as authentic as this.
The pieces in this part of the house might not be for sale, but even the chance to appreciate them is a rare treat for Drew.
Oh, my God, look at this. Oh, look at that table. You've got that en suite as well, the console suite. Is there another one of those?
There's another one up.
You've got two of those.
Step,
that'd be
those.
About right.
Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, my life. This is quite staggering for me. Because these would have been known makers that they'd have used for the house that had been people of standing, particularly for that one. But these feel like these have been made for here.
Yeah, got the family crest as well.
Yeah. It doesn't get better, it just continues. Look at the tapestries on the wall, look at the ceiling. I mean, really, look at the ceiling. It's quite incredible. Fabulous pieces of furniture. It just goes on and on. I can't tell you how much I love this place when James goes on holiday and changes the locks. It's it's pretty fantastic. William. Drew, nice to meet you. How are you doing?
Yeah, very well.
So, blimey, look at that.
Yeah,
wow.
The brides love the staircase coming down.
Amazing. That's all cast iron, isn't it? What's unusual is this original finish. So they painted the cast iron to look like wood. The design of the interior of the house is, it's a real melting pot of different styles. Come in and you've got huge cast iron Rococo swirls, and you've got neoclassical columns with sort of Georgian pierced plaster and painted decoration. You find this quite often in English houses where they basically nicked lots of different styles because it showed you had travelled, you'd been around the world, you understood all these different styles. It's very glamorous, that's for sure.
This is one of our rooms full of old junk.
What I love deeply about coming to these houses is they have their so-called junk rooms. Now, I wish everybody had a junk room like this. They're just great. You go in, you think, look at this, how lucky am I? This is my job, to wander around people's houses and sift through their old stuff. Don't know about you, but I just love it. It just never, ever gets boring.
Look at this.
Hello.
How'd you do?
Drew, how are you?
David.
Nice to meet you.
Tess.
Hi,
Tess.
Drew.
Lovely to meet you.
And you. Hello, doggies.
Hello.
Well, wow, what a place.
Thank
fabulous.
You.
This is how to do an antique shop. First thoughts on walking through the door. Wow, this is good. This is incredibly well done. It's been put together by people who are at the very top of their game. It looks fabulous. The colours and the combination is very exotic. It's very worldly. It's very design-led. It's all the super desirable things that you want when you have a really nice house to put them in.